Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. The link to Bauer's YouTube video announcement is down in the description of this video. So if you want to go check it out, the link will be down below in the description. It'll be the first link down there. The link will be blue. So if you want to go check it out, down in the description below. So leading up to Bauer's announcement video, there was some speculation on where Bauer would go. It was first reported that Bauer would be going to the Mets and signing with the Mets. But then later on throughout the day, there was more in regards to the Dodgers. I thought that Bauer was signing with the Mets. There was a lot of speculation around that. But this whole process and Bauer deciding to go with the Dodgers really shows that, you know, there's clearly some inconsistencies, right? In, you know, what MLB reporters actually report. And what's actually going on behind the scenes, there's clearly a disconnect there on truly what is happening in MLB free agency. And I think that, you know, Trevor Bauer and his agent Rachel Luba, they're shedding light. They're shedding light on what actually takes place. And we don't know as outsiders. And that's just a thing. We want to know everything as you know, as MLB fans, as followers of the sport, as Trevor Bauer fans, we want to know what's truthfully going on, but we don't know the experience. We're outsiders. We don't know. We don't have firsthand experience of the, you know, the free agency happenings, the contract, the signing, the process, the negotiation. We don't see that. A lot of that's off screen. A lot of, you know, that's pretty much all off camera. We don't see exactly what is going on there. Down in the description below of this video, I'll have the details on his signing and how much money he'll be making. So if you just want to see it written out, check the description down below. All the details will be down there, as well as where I've gotten the information. I'll go ahead and source it. So let's break down Trevor Bauer's deal with the Los Angeles Dodgers. It is a record-breaking deal, guys. The Los Angeles Dodgers are easily going over the tax threshold this year, just due to this deal. And that means the Dodgers are going to have to pay an outrageous amount of tax just this year because of this deal with Bauer. So here it is, as confirmed by MLB.com's executive reporter Mark Feinsand and ESPN's Jeff Passan. So here it is. Trevor Bauer is getting $102 million for the next 3 years from the Dodgers, per sources. He has opt-outs after every year, first year, second year, and then, of course, the third year when the contract's fully over with. Bauer is expected to make $40 million in 2021, $45 million in 2022. Overall, he'll be the highest paid player in MLB history in 2021. And if he stays, if Bauer decides not to opt out and stays with the contract, Bauer will then again be the highest paid player in 2022. What a deal done by his agent, Rachel Luba. He has, you know, all the world to thank her for, you know, the negotiations. Now, I talked about the Dodgers going over the tax threshold. Here are the details by ESPN's Jeff Passan. The Dodgers are blasting through the luxury tax threshold with Trevor Bauer's deal. Before Bauer was signed, the total payroll for the Dodgers as it sat was at $205 million, which was roughly about $5 million under the threshold. So $210 million is the threshold that the Dodgers were facing. Boom, after the deal was done, now the Dodgers are sitting at roughly $240 million. Think about that, $240 million for their player salaries just this year alone. They're about $30 million over the tax threshold, and they've still been in talks about re-signing Justin Turner, which would only add more money to the payroll, right? If they sign anybody else, they're going to be, you know, adding another player, which will add more payroll. So it's World Series or bust for the Dodgers. There's no doubt about it with this deal. It's World Series or bust for the Los Angeles Dodgers. And I want to get into my opinions on the deal. which we'll do so right now. Listen, I know that you guys are going to probably sound off in the comments section of this video down below. If you disagree with me, let me know down there. I really don't care. I'll have a conversation with you. I really don't. This signing does have a potential to ruin competition. Definitely in the National League, maybe not the entire MLB. Maybe that's too far-fetched, but definitely in the National League. That rotation is just, I mean, Kershaw, Walker Buehler. I don't know why I'm saying his last name like that. You know who I'm talking about. Trevor Bauer, David Price. Those four guys are literally aces right now in the making. You know, Walker is, he's a ace in the making, but the rest of them, they're number one starters. They are. They're number one starters. And then this doesn't even mention Tony Gonsolin, Dustin May, Julio Urias. What about Brusdar Graterol? That's an up-and-coming guy. I mean, Lord have mercy, not to mention their bullpen. They don't even need to re-sign Justin Turner. They don't sound off down below. They don't even need to re-sign Justin Turner. I mean, the pitching is going to be unreal, unmatched. If the Dodgers, as a club, don't have the best ERA and the best pitching stats in damn near every category, I will be shocked. You know, why does one guy change all of that? Which, you're right, one guy doesn't change it all. But the Dodgers have signed quite a few bullpen arms as well. You know, they've got Blake Treinen. They re-signed Blake Treinen. They've got, what is it, Tommy Canley. They signed Tommy Canley. I mean, it's, I don't know, man. The Dodgers, they're building a dynasty right in front of our eyes. And that's what it is. It's a dynasty. It reminds me of the whole Warriors situation. Yep. Just as a recap, I don't hate Trevor Bauer. I don't hate him as a person. I would never say that. I don't hate him. I dislike the team that he went to. That team is the defending champions. They really don't even need Bauer to compete. They didn't have him last year, right? And now they have him, and it's just it just adds to the unbalance of talent, if that makes any sense. It just adds to that dynamic. Being a D-backs fan, I do hate it as a D-backs fan, but you know, in the end of the day, if this makes Bauer happy, then that's all that matters. What's it matter what I think? It's his life, it's his deal, and it's his lifestyle. So, you know, kudos to you, Bauer. Please subscribe down below to the channel. I'd really appreciate it. The channel is at 72 subscribers right now, and I am doing a giveaway. Once the channel hits 100 subscribers, I will be doing a giveaway. It is a DualShock 4. It's a blue PS4 controller. I have a video already up on the channel, so I'll throw a card up on this video up here somewhere. If you want to go check out that video, I'd appreciate it. But let's get to 100 subscribers. I'm really close. Please help me reach my goal. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks. And that's going to do it for this video, guys. If you've enjoyed the video and if you've enjoyed the content, leave a like on this video, subscribe down below, turn post notifications on, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Tabor time out. Peace.